New Moon Mania is in full swing ahead of the midnight release of the second installment in the Twilight saga. And one of the main reasons is this young guy right here, Robert Pattinson. He's back as a century-old vampire, Edward Cullen, and finds himself in a fight for his life. Take a look. Good stuff. Robert, welcome back. It's nice to see you.
Too.
Last time you were here, it was in advance of a little movie, the first one, mm-hmm. Twilight, and that movie went on to make $380 million at the box office. The DVD sold 8 million copies. Did you have any idea last time you were sitting on this show what you were in store for?
Yeah, I actually bought up a whole load of the DVDs and sold them with the back of a truck. I had no idea whatsoever. Everyone always asks me, and no one believes me either, but I had absolutely no idea what was going to happen with it.
It turned your life upside down. It catapulted you to a different level of fame. I mean, we just saw what happened when you walked outside. What's it like, and, you know, kind of give me the wide-ranging view, what's it like to live in your shoes these days?
I wish I could give a more wide understanding of what it's like, but I mean, I feel exactly the same. I mean, it's kind of, I speak in an American accent when I'm talking to crowds because it's so separate to my actual life. I mean, I still feel like I'm kind of acting. I mean, I think that's the way that I don't go completely mad.
It's so flattering on the one hand, Robert, but on the other hand, do you ever wish there were times when you could put the genie back in the bottle?
Only about my teeth. I had to change my teeth a little bit for the first movie, and that's the only regret I have.
You liked your old teeth better?
Yeah. Oh God, I was supposed to do this brace thing, and I never wore the brace, and so now I've kind of damaged my teeth permanently. That's the only regret I have.
One of the things people may recognize when this movie opens at midnight is that because it stays true to the book, you're not in this one as much mm-hmm. as you were the first one. How do you feel about that?
Well, I'm glad it's true to the book. I mean, Jesus, they'd go crazy if
it would be worse than this.
I get sacrificed. No, I always liked this book. I thought it was the most complex book, and I thought it was, especially for Edward's character, the most relatable story for me. I like the idea of a guy who, you know, the more in love with someone you fall, the more you kind of lose control of the relationship and kind of attack and destroy it. And I always thought that was interesting.
Kristen Stewart was here the other day, and she said there are times she finds herself falling into her character, that she likes the character and she kind of takes it on, and you say you feel like you're acting sometimes. You like this character, this guy, this kind of perfect romantic?
It's funny, I mean, because I never play it as that, ever, and that's what I don't understand about
why all this has happened.
Yeah, like, I mean, I understand that the character in the book is obviously, I mean, you can see why it's a kind of ideal guy, but I mean, the book is through Bella's eyes, and she's madly in love with him and infatuated with him. So, I mean, I've always had to find the negative aspects of it.
You can't go to an airport, you can't go to a magazine stand without looking at you on the cover of one of these entertainment magazines or the other kind of magazines as well. I'm going to give you a chance to put some things to rest right here.
The other kind of magazines?
The tabloid magazines. You know. So let's do a little tabloid true or false. These are all things that have all been written about you in the past year alone, okay? Mm-hmm. True or false, you've been dating nonstop. I mean nonstop.
Literally nonstop, yes.
Okay, good. True. You're dating one of your co-stars. Her name rhymes with Tristan Blewett.
Tristan Blewett. There was a Liston Hewitt.
Okay, good.
Last year.
So that would be true.
Yes.
Okay, you got engaged.
Yes.
Okay, you were hit by a cab.
Yes.
You had a drug overdose.
Yes.
Are any of these false?
No. I actually come up with these rumors myself.
Because it just works for you, right?
Agent.
And this talked about butt accident. What, butt injury? What was that?
I think that was my mother giving birth.
That's horrible. I don't understand it, but you know what? I hope you're at least enjoying some of this. I really do, because there are very few actors or actresses who get to say that they're living in this kind of a predicament right now.
No, I mean, it's kind of incredible. I mean, especially as I was literally, the day before I did this audition, I was going to quit acting. And because I never got any jobs, so I guess it's not really quitting when you're not getting jobs. That's just surrendering to fate.
It all worked out. And this new installment, the second installment, New Moon, opens in theaters nationwide, whether you say tonight or tomorrow, midnight. So good luck with that.
Thank you very much.
Thanks for coming by, Robert. It's nice to see you.